Spring is coming, and soon people will be outdoors, taking in all nature has to offer. Unfortunately, one of those offers is a devious vine called Toxicodendron radicans. You know it as poison ivy. Hit me with it! What is it about poison ivy that makes you break out in a rash and scratch like crazy? We called in chemist Jennifer Novotney, the 2014 chemistry champion.
The culprit in poison ivy is a compound called urushiol. It's a chemical compound.
Sorry, what was that again?
Right? It's a weird sounding name. Urushiol is a family of chemical compounds that soak through the skin and cause an allergic reaction in your dermis. That's the layer under the top layer of skin. It can be absorbed in as little as 10 minutes, so unless you have soap and water handy, you're kind of out of luck.
A lot of people don't know this, but it's not just touch that can put poison ivy in your system.
You can actually breathe poison ivy. If it's being burned, the smoke can carry the compound, and if you get urushiol into your lungs, it can cause a very severe allergic reaction.
Usher's oil, or whatever it's called, also has a lot of staying power. If you're exposed to it, you really need to wash everything thoroughly. Here's why.
Urushiol can actually live on a surface for up to 5 years. So if you were exposed to poison ivy, be sure that everything that might have had contact gets a thorough washing, including boots and equipment.
It can even take some time for your body to react to poison ivy, so just because you've showered doesn't mean it's gone.
Someone exposed to poison ivy can sometimes take up to a week to show symptoms, but generally, a rash will develop within 24 hours of exposure to urushiol.
Okay, so a grassy knoll, or whatever it's called, leaves your skin rashy and sometimes even produces blisters. So what can you do to get some much-needed relief? Look no further than chemistry for some of that sweet, sweet relief. Oatmeal baths are actually a pretty solid home remedy for treating poison ivy. Scientists have studied avianthramides, another hard-to-pronounce compound. They're a type of polyphenol chemical found in oatmeal, and they seem to have an anti-inflammatory effect on cells. So a sticky oatmeal bath might actually soothe your itch, even though it sounds pretty friggin' gross. But how exactly do those polyphenols work? No idea. It's still under investigation. Anyway, there you have it, folks. For more remedies, treatments, and tips, check out our Life Hack series, and don't forget to subscribe for a weekly dose of chemistry goodness. And hey, check out this well-dressed guy.
Remember, folks, leaves of three, let them be. We brought Jennifer on as a reactions guest after she rocked the science communications world in 2014 by winning the Chemistry Champions Contest. Think you might be the next Dr. Kiki Sanford or Bill Nye? Well, we're running Chem Champs again in 2015. If you're an ACS member 35 years or younger, you are eligible to enter. The contest will be bigger and bolder in 2015 with events here in Washington, D.C. and in Boston at the ACS Fall National Meeting. Prizes include career networking with professional science communicators, opportunity to tell your story to Hollywood, and this fabulous trophy. Details are at www.acs.org/chemchamps. We're taking entries until April 8, 2015.